lived a very long time, which is very amazing. But let me read the first part of the obituary this morning or this afternoon with you. Jeanette M. Jones died on June 8th, 2024, at Sentara Albemarle Medical Center in Elizabeth City, North Carolina. She was 102 years old. Ms. Jones was the widow of the late Charles C. Jones, first sergeant retired. The eldest of four, Ms. Jones was born to John and Marguerite Johns McNally on October 29th, 1921 in Tacoma, Washington. As a military spouse, she would go on to live in Japan and Germany, as well as much of the United States. Due to her extensive travels, Ms. Jones made lifelong friends, many of whom she hosted in her home. And late in life, she worked at DePaul School of Nursing in Norfolk, or as some people say, Norfolk. I can't say it's Norfolk. I'm from there. Virginia, as a resident director, where many of the students still remember her fondly. I'm going to save this last part real quick for my message. But I want to share something with you about two scriptures of comfort at this time. Psalm 23 says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." But let me carry you back to the New Testament, 2 Thessalonians, in chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. He says, "Now our Lord Jesus Christ himself, and God, even our Father, which hath loved us, and have given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good and work and word," or word and work. I got to share a little bit with her daughter about some things and learn so much. Well, it's amazing. She lived to be 102 years old. And the music, I will tell you, whoever picked it out, great, because it really shows her personality and gives me a little more idea of what she was like. She was a military spouse. She loved to travel. I'm pretty sure her house was in order, no matter what. Or I'm pretty sure the meals were in order when you had the family to get gatherings and stuff where, you know, she knew what needed to be where and who needed to be where, who was going to sit where, or vice versa. But I'm sure through her travels that she had met very many people, she probably never forgot a name or a face. She probably made a lot of people feel comfortable when she would see some of them travel and they would be stationed back where she was with her husband, and she was probably the first one that would greet you at the door. She loved holiday dinners. Holidays were important to her, as I could see through the pictures there of the different times that y'all had different things going on. But a part of that, she was the matriarch. She was the cornerstone for you all. She was kind and generous, not only to just her family and friends, but even to strangers. I hear she loved to shop. Probably couldn't get her out of Hallmark or something like that. I'm dating myself a little bit there. I do remember those days where I used to get used to tell Mom or Nana, "Hey, we need to get out of here. Really? Come on, let's go." But I'm pretty sure she could stay in there. You know, she probably did that because she loved to give gifts. And that was one of the gift stores back then, too. She loved her grands and her great-grands. Family was more important to her than anything. But also, again, she made it a point to keep in touch. She made it a point to make sure you all were okay, to check on you, to tell you happy birthday, happy graduation, or even just to check on you. But she loved to make sure everybody's birthday was made special. And I think every grandma wants to do that, not only for her children, but also for her grandkids. Because I know sometimes, even I said this to my parents with my children, and I've always said, look, you treat them better than you treated us. And I always used to tell the kids, I said, it's not the same person, trust me. But it don't matter. I'm a grandparent, so grandparents are going to love on their grands more than anything. But the best part is Miss Jeanette not only loved her family, but loved her students, loved the people she talked to, loved the people she shared with. It didn't matter, because that brings me to this part here. It says, Miss Jones will be remembered for her positive outlook and her generosity. She befriended nearly anyone she encountered, cashiers, beauticians, home health aides, you name it. They all loved her, as did her family with a 102-year-old had grown quite large. The best part is I know probably most of the families here, I know there's more probably, but the thing is when you all come together in numbers to share with one another. And this shows that Miss Jeanette's love, she didn't keep it to herself. She shared it with you all, with the family. And it shows today because of everyone who was here, not just family, but friends and those who may have known her or talked to her. And that's the best part. And it shows me, gives me the example of how God said to us, you know, he said, I'm going to give you my son who died on the cross for your sins because I allowed that to happen, because he allowed it to happen. But the best part is this, his love was so important for us today that even Miss Jeanette even showed this same example of love. No matter where she went, she was going to make sure people were taken care of, family was taken care of. And I will say, when you're in the military, you are family. You may not be blood, but you are family. And I bet she was one of those ones first at the door with something like a plate of cookies or even a quick hug to say, hey, I'm glad to see you again. We'll now go into our next song and then I'll go into my message.
Make me an angel. can hear them there buzzing. And I ain't done nothing since I woke up today.
In Psalm 46, 1 through 3, it says this. It says, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. As we look, those who die in Christ claim a victory. They claim a victory that we look forward to. And he says in some questions here, he goes, where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and power of the sin of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to work of the Lord, because you know that our labor in the Lord is not in vain. And that comes from 1 Corinthians 15, verses 55 through 58. And this is where the Apostle Paul shares that with us. He's basically telling us that our work is not in vain on this earth. It is not just because we do it. But I want you to remember this song, Amazing Grace. And as I thought about Miss Jeanette, it occurred to me that this song basically summed up her life. She's shown grace in everything that she had done. Grace to her students, grace to her children, grace to her grandchildren, family, friends. Even though she had just met, she had shown grace. But as we look, those who die in Christ enter a final rest. In Revelation 14, 13, he says, then I heard a voice from heaven say, write this, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labor, for their deeds will follow them. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Miss Jeanette was the kind of person who was at peace with her life. She lived it to the fullest. She didn't let anything stop her from doing anything or anything that she wanted to do. She made sure it was special. And I'm sure during her times of moves, there were times where she was like over bombarded with things and with her husband or with, in, you know, how military life is, or some do, where you're always on the go. It's never stopped. It's once they hand you your orders, you got to get started once you get them. And I'm sure she made the time to make sure to tell everyone she knew that they were leaving, or that we'll see you later somewhere in your moves or whatever. Or even just getting out and doing her own thing after her husband had retired. She got out, she did things, but she knew that she had other things, but I'm pretty sure she was the type of person that would stop and say, hey, I'm going to take time for you. But she showed that grace. But as we look here, now she's at rest with the Lord. She has peace. She's at complete rest. And her health is very well and with the Lord. She's not hurting, no more pain, no more sorrow. And I'm pretty sure she was not the type of person to show you at times, and she was that rock that was one that would push forward. But as we look, though, those who die in the Lord leave a legacy. In Deuteronomy 30, 19 through 20, he says, as Moses was at the end of his life, he desired to leave a message with those who were closest to him. And his message was only two words here. Choose life. Choose life. Choose to do those things that you see somebody needing help. And it can be as simple as a smile, or even telling somebody who looks down, hey, good morning, hope you have a great day. Just a few words can change somebody's life. It is interesting how some people grow old and are filled with life, and some people just grow old. But Miss Jeanette, we can tell she chose life, not only through the pictures, but also through the music. She lived every day to the fullest, going back to when she encountered the cashiers or beauticians or health aides that were more worried about either taking care of her in the line or the beautician making sure her hair was right, making sure that she stayed happy, or the health aides, home health aides, where they were more concerned about her health, but she was probably more concerned about what was going on with them. But she lived every day to the fullest, and she never gave up. I don't know how you do it to live to be 102 years old or older. Now, I have read and seen on TV or whatever, and y'all may have seen this on, I think, Facebook or news or something. But anyway, I remember this one example. This lady, I don't know if she's still living or not, but she drank a Dr. Pepper every day. I'm a Mountain Dew Coke fan, but I used to drink Dr. Pepper, but not anymore. But thing is really, is that Dr. Pepper, one Dr. Pepper, going to make you better each day? Might bring your sugar up. But the thing is this, as Moses has put it, choose life. Because it brings us all the way to the New Testament in John 3:16. He says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And here's a challenge I want to give you all and just share with you, but we must take the challenge to choose life and give our lives to others. We can stay to ourselves and close ourselves up in our homes as much as we can, as we did during COVID, where it was enforced. Stay home, don't go out. Stay away from people, mask up. Yeah, we can use all those precautions. But the thing is this. If you believe in your Lord Jesus Christ, you're not going to take but the precaution knowing that you got something to look forward to. And that is to live your life right for the Lord and to just live life to the fullest. Don't half do it. Go all the way. Because I know Miss Jeanette would probably be like, don't sit there. And I could see her as a nursing teacher. I mean, good Lord, she's probably a drill sergeant. She'd probably get upset with the students, and then she'd love on them afterwards. But she was making sure they were doing what needed to be done the right way and how it was to be done. And that's the same with our Father in heaven. He gets on us at times in different ways, but he still loves us, just like a parent. I remember as a child growing up, my parents would be like, I'm upset with you. And I was like, I'm sorry, Mom, Dad. Okay, then they love on you, you know. But I was hard-headed. We'd do it again, you know, till we learned. But the thing is this. We live life to the fullest with no limitations, and things will happen, just as much as Miss Jeanette did throughout her life. Because I'm pretty sure anything she planned, especially a gift that wasn't even for a birthday, just because she wanted to do it, a lot of thought was put into it when she gave it to you. And you knew it when you got it. The same as our Lord Jesus Christ. He's given us that gift of his Son to die on the sins for our sins on the cross. And we get to live that life. But I want to tell you also, today is not a day we say goodbye to her. Today's a day that we say, I'll see you later. Because we get that chance to be home with her one day. And I can say we can be jealous of her, because I know she's probably having a good old time up there. But let's take her legacy and share it, not only with our family as it grows, but with our friends and those who we come into contact with. Let us pray. Father, as we close today, I am so grateful that I got to be a part of Miss Jeanette's service. It definitely was truly an honor. But I am so grateful to learn just so much that I could about her and to share her life with the family and friends, and as I got to learn from her family about her. But the best part is we know she lived a full life to where she did whatever she could to make things happen for others. She had that servanthood of wanting to be there for those who were in need or those who had a special day or occasion, and she wanted to make it even better. And I just pray that we all remember that, and especially the family remember that during those times, the holidays and dinners they have, and especially the friends here. And I'm pretty sure she was that bright light that you didn't even need a light on in the house to even see to enjoy a wonderful meal. But her smile and probably her laughter just carried on, or the little quirky things she probably said that they would laugh about. But I just pray those things don't ever stop. I pray that they continue on. But I also pray that you be with this family and allow them to lean on you during this time. Because we know Miss Jeanette's not going to be able to make that phone call to check on us. But the one thing we can do is check up on her and just look up and say, hey, we miss you. Or we love you. Or if you have a question, you know, whatever it may be. But I just pray that you be with them throughout this time. And I just pray that you be with every one of us as we go into our separate homes and separate places. And as we travel, keep us safe. And it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.